Get those fingers open and up. Don't forget to have that other hand nice and big and open. Good, another.
Parkinson's disease is a progressive neurological condition of the brain, and so it's where the brain produces not enough dopamine.
Associate Professor Michelle Calasaya studies how movements are affected by Parkinson's disease.
One of the really important things for Parkinson's disease is actually exercise. And so if you think about someone who goes for a run and gets that high, they don't just get an endorphin hit, they get a dopamine hit as well.
Good, even more Harley. Good, keep going.
It has an amazing effect on all the motor symptoms, potentially slowing down the progression of those symptoms. Could also have a good effect on fatigue, mood, anxiety, sleep and quality of life as well. I've always loved running, especially trail running. I mean, gosh, when I was 24, I ran the 80-kilometre Cradle Mountain run. It was at the end of quite a big run, running downhill, and my leg just started to feel a bit strange and I started to get some cramping in my toes.
The cramping increased, but at first there were no answers.
I started to feel that I was twisted, but that was actually the slowing down of my leg. I started to have some trouble typing with stiffness in my fingers. My arm started to not swing as much.
Up to one in five patients are like Michelle, diagnosed with early onset Parkinson's disease.
There wasn't a lot of support out there for people my age, particularly here in Tasmania, you know.
And things aren't much better on the mainland. Not only is treatment hard to access in many areas, we don't even have national clinical guidelines for Parkinson's.
Come on, Harley. Come on, get down.
There's a man called Harley Stanton who used to be a World Health Organization scientist, and he could see that there was nothing happening, and he has an incredible talent for bringing people together and getting people to collaborate.
Well, within Australia, we've got 200,000 people with Parkinson's. That's about four times as many people as there is with MS. It's 10 times more people with Parkinson's than there is with MND.
And those numbers of Australians with Parkinson's are set to double.
By 2040, we'll have 400,000. It's growing faster than the ageing population, and we need to overcome a lot of the issues around what I call the three S's: the stigma, the shame, the stereotype. When I first was diagnosed, like many others, I went silent. I told my family only. I didn't want other people to know. It's often a personalised shame, because of the way in which Parkinson's is often perceived in the society, taking away from the personhood, the self-esteem that people have within them, their own identity.
Harley's advocacy has created the National Parkinson's Alliance, and they want action for this incurable disease.
Canberra was a great opportunity to bring together people to the National Parkinson's Summit, which was an idea that I dreamed of a few years ago.
Oh, gosh. Aren't you two so cute?
If we can do something now, we're going to be able to save a lot of people's lives, and it'll be the people living with Parkinson's that are going to benefit from this down the line.
You wouldn't wish Parkinson's on your worst enemy. You just wouldn't. But I also know now, with the help of Harley, that you can turn things around. I think this is the plus about something like PD Warriors, which was started up here. It's a fantastic group of people. We have a wonderful physiotherapist called Adam. He's just delightful.
As fast as we can. Ta-da! Back. Ta-da! Well done.
Parkinson's impacts the whole of the family. It doesn't just impact the person. It's unrelenting. It never goes away. It's always there at some stage in the day or something. It'll remind you.
As Michael Fox said, Parkinson's is a disease that keeps on taking. So you've got to fight against that. It's important to encourage others, especially when they're struggling. I don't regard myself as fortunate to have the disease, but I regard myself fortunate to be able to be in a situation to help others.
I don't want people to feel excluded from society. I want people to be able to own their Parkinson's, to come out and talk about it, and to make change.
I take medication every 4 hours. Once that medication starts to go down, then you do start to get stiff again. It's about making sure that those medications are taken on time and keeping fit and active. I'm lucky because I've always loved exercise, but, you know, also I think it makes you think about what you want to do with your life and, yeah, go and do those things, yeah.
Such a beautiful, beautiful story.
Yeah. Anything that can help people in that situation, if, even if it's, especially if it's lateral, is a great thing.
Yeah. And it's impressive the way that community is so important in this as well. You know, there's the medical treatment, but there's the physical treatment, but just how good being a part of a community makes you feel and helping somebody else. It's a great example of, you know, choose your attitude and you almost choose your destiny.
Well, you know who else is a great example of that? Is Michael J. Fox, who they mentioned. And His documentary, we had him on the show last year when it came out. Honestly, it is extraordinary. And I mentioned this because those guys love it. The Harley, Michelle and Davina absolutely love it, and they would. It's so informative as to give you an insight into what this disease is, what it's like.
Well, I think without people like Michael J. Fox, you still wouldn't realise what this disease does and what it means for so many people.
I can't speak highly enough for it, so seek it out.